sulfonamides and cotrimoxazole. These are the first antimicrobial agents effective against pyogenic infections. Prontosil was a dye used to treat experimental streptococcal infection in mice. Later found that prontosil breaks in our body to release sulfonilamide, which is an active compound. Large number of sulfonamides were produced in subsequent years and extensively used. But because of rapid emergence of bacterial resistance and availability of more safer and effective antibiotics, these sulfonamides are currently used only in combination with other antibiotics. This is the structure of sulfonilamide. Chemistry of sulfonamides. All sulfonamides are derivatives of sulfonilamide. Individual members differ in N1 substitution, which governs solubility, potency, and pharmacokinetic property. A free amino group in the para position is required for its antibacterial activity. Classification of sulfonamides based on the duration: short acting, 4 to 8 hours, intermediate acting, 8 to 12 hours, long acting, 7 days. And topical sulfonamides are also available. Oral but not absorbed is the last group. In the classification, short acting group: sulfadiazine, sulfadiamidine. Intermediate acting group: sulfamoxazole, sulfamethoxazole. Long acting group: sulfadoxin, sulfamethopyrazine. Under topical sulfonamides: sodium sulfacetamide, maffinide acetate, silver sulfadiazine. And the last group: orally given sulfonamides but not absorbed. Under that, sulfasalazine. Antibacterial activity of sulfonamides. These sulfonamides are primarily bacteriostatic against many gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. But bactericidal concentrations are attained in urine. Those organisms still sensitive to sulfonamides are many streptococcal pyogenes, Haemophilus influenza, Haemophilus ducreyi, Calimobacterium granulomatis, Vibrio cholera, Chlamydiae, Actinomyces, Nocardia, and Toxoplasma. Resistant organisms to sulfonamides are Staph aureus, Gonococci, Meningococci, Pneumococci, E. coli, Shigella, few streptococcal pyogenes, Streptococcus viridans, all these are resistant. And also anaerobic bacteria are resistant to sulfonamides. Many bacteria synthesize their own folic acid. These bacteria will take para-aminobenzoic acid, which is a constituent of folic acid, from the medium, whereas humans utilize preformed folic acid from the diet. Sulfonamides inhibit bacterial dihydroptyroate synthase enzyme. Coming to the folic acid pathway, pyridine and para-aminobenzoic acid combine together to form dihydroptyroic acid by the enzyme dihydroptyroate synthase. And this dihydroptyroic acid conjugate with glutamate to form dihydrofolic acid. Then dihydrofolic acid converts into tetrahydrofolic acid by the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase. Then the tetrahydrofolic acid is utilized for the synthesis of DNA. Pus and tissue extracts contain more amount of purines and pyrimidines that will decrease bacterial requirement for folic acid. So, this pus and tissue extract antagonize sulfonamide action. Sulfonamides are structurally similar to para-aminobenzoic acid. Being structurally similar to para-aminobenzoic acid, these sulfonamides get incorporated to form an altered folic acid, which is metabolically injurious. In this picture, you can see the altered folic acid formation due to incorporation of sulfonamides. Bacteria will develop resistance to sulfonamides by different mechanisms. Through decreased transport into the bacteria, and the bacteria will cause increased synthesis of para-aminobenzoic acid, and also decreasing the enzyme affinity for sulfonamides. And the last one, bacteria will adopt an alternate pathway for the synthesis of folic acid. When an organism is resistant to one sulfonamide, it is resistant to them all, and no cross resistance is seen between sulfonamides and other antibiotics. Pharmacokinetics of sulfonamides, all are well observed orally, and the extent of plasmaprotein binding differs, and all these are widely distributed in the body. Some will enter into CSF, cross placenta, and secreted in the milk. Sulfonamides displace bilirubin from the plasma protein binding sites. All these sulfonamides are metabolized by acetylation reaction in the liver and may precipitate in acidic urine, causing crystalluria as a side effect. All are excreted in the urine, partly as the parent drug and partly as the metabolite. Uses of sulfonamides. Systemic use of sulfonamides alone is obsolete. Nowadays, they are used in combination. Examples: sulfadoxin plus pyrimethamine combination is given in malaria. Sulfadiazine plus pyrimethamine combination is given in toxoplasmosis. Sulfomethoxazole and trimethoprim combination, called as cotrimoxazole, is given for many bacterial infections. Uses of topical sulfonamides. Sodium sulfoacetamide is used in trachoma, inclusion conjunctivitis. Mafenide acetate is given for burn dressing. It will prevent the infections. Silver sulfadiazine is also given for burn dressing, which prevents the infection. Here you can see the pictures of topical sulfonamides. Sulfoacetamide, topical suspension. Mafenide acetate cream. Silver sulfadiazine cream. Sulfasalazin, orally given sulfonamide but not absorbed. It is used in inflammatory bowel disease, ulcerative colitis, and also rheumatoid arthritis. Sulfasalazin, after taking into our body, splits into two compounds: 5-aminosalicylic acid and sulfapyridine. Coming to the adverse effects of sulfonamides, commonly nausea, vomiting, epigastric pain or seen. Crystalluria, which occurs due to insoluble sulfonamides in the urine. This can be minimized by taking plenty of fluids and also alkalinization of urine. Hypersensitivity reactions like rashes, urticaria, drug fever, and also Steven Johnson syndrome, exfoliative dermatitis are seen. Hepatitis is rare. Hemolysis in G6PD deficiency patients in a dose-dependent manner. Kernicterus in newborn. This occurs due to displacement of bilirubin from the plasma protein binding sites. In this picture, you can see Kernicterus in newborn.
Cotrimoxazole, a fixed dose combination antibiotic. It is a combination of two antibiotics, trimethoprim and sulfomethoxazole. In these two, the first one, trimethoprim, it belongs to a group known as diaminopyrimidines, which is related to an anti-malarial drug, pyrimethamine. The second drug, sulfomethoxazole, belongs to sulfonamides. Coming to the mechanism of action of cotrimoxazole, it causes sequential blockade of bacterial folate metabolism. Many bacteria synthesize their own folic acid. Para-aminobenzoic acid is a constituent of folic acid. Bacteria will take para-aminobenzoic acid from the medium, whereas humans will utilize preformed folic acid from the diet. Coming to the folic acid pathway, in bacteria, pyridine and para-aminobenzoic acid both combine to form dihydroteroic acid by the enzyme dihydroteroate synthase. And this dihydroteroic acid conjugates with glutamic acid or glutamate to form dihydrofolic acid by the enzyme dihydrofolate synthase. And this dihydrofolic acid is converted into tetrahydrofolic acid by the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase. So finally, tetrahydrofolic acid is formed, which is utilized for the synthesis of bacterial DNA. These sulfonamides and trimethoprim cause sequential blockade. That is, sulfonamides will inhibit the first step in this pathway. Also, sulfonamides are structurally similar to para-aminobenzoic acid. So, they competitively inhibit the union of pyridine and para-aminobenzoic acid. Coming to trimethoprim, it inhibits the third step in this pathway. It inhibits the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase. The tetrahydrofolic acid, which is formed finally, is utilized for the synthesis of bacterial DNA. Sulfomethoxazole mechanism. Already we have seen, it inhibits the bacterial dihydropteroid synthesis. Apart from that, these sulfonamides, which are structurally similar to para-aminobenzoic acid, they get incorporated to form an altered folic acid, which is metabolically injurious. Trimethoprim mechanism. It inhibits the bacterial dihydrofolate reductase. Here, we find two types of enzymes, bacterial and mammalian. Trimethoprim is 50,000 times more active against bacterial enzyme than mammalian enzyme. So, human folate metabolism is not interfered at the antibacterial concentrations of trimethoprim. Individually, both these drugs, trimethoprim and sulfomethoxazole, are bacteriostatic. Bacteriostatic means an antibiotic which will stop the growth and multiplication of bacteria. Now, the combination of these two drugs, trimethoprim and sulfomethoxazole, is bactericidal. Bactericidal means an antibiotic which can kill bacteria. So both are synergistic. So this is an example for supra-additive synergistic combination. Maximum synergism is seen when the organism is sensitive to both the drugs. Now the question is, why sulfomethoxazole was selected for combining with trimethoprim? There are so many other sulfonamides. Why this was chosen? Because both are having nearly same half-life period, that is nearly 10 hours. Optimal synergy in case of most organisms is exhibited at a concentration ratio of 20:1, sulfomethoxazole is to trimethoprim, 20:1. This ratio is obtained in plasma when these two drugs are given in a dose ratio of 5:1. Why? Because trimethoprim has high lipid solubility and large volume of distribution than sulfomethoxazole. So, trimethoprim enters many tissues, reaches prostatic and vaginal fluids, crosses the blood-brain barrier, placenta. So, it attains low plasma concentration. So, the optimal ratio of the two drugs is sulfomethoxazole is to trimethoprim, 5:1, or trimethoprim is to sulfomethoxazole is 1:5. You can see some fixed dose combination tablets, trimethoprim 80 milligrams, sulfomethoxazole 400 milligrams. DS tablets are also available. DS means double strength tablets, where trimethoprim 160 milligrams, sulfomethoxazole 800 milligrams. That is called double strength tablet. Pediatric tablet is also available, where trimethoprim is 20 milligrams, sulfomethoxazole is 100 milligrams. Pediatric suspension is also available, where trimethoprim 40 milligrams and sulfomethoxazole 200 milligrams are present in per 5 ml of suspension.
Pharmacokinetics of cotrimoxazole. Trimethoprim is 40% plasma protein bound. Sulfomethoxazole has 65% plasma protein binding capacity. Trimethoprim is partly metabolized in the liver and excreted in the urine. Antibacterial spectrum of cotrimoxazole. Spectrum of both these drugs overlap considerably. Additional organisms covered by this combination are Salmonella typhi, Serratia, Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Yersinia enterocolitica, Pneumocystis jirovecii, Staph aureus, Streptococcus pyogenes, Shigella, Enteropathogenic E. coli, Haemophilus influenza, Gonococci, and Meningococci. Resistance to this combination has been slow to develop compared to either drug alone. But widespread use of this combination over a long period resulted in reduced responsiveness. Bacteria develop resistance to trimethoprim through plasmid-mediated acquisition of DHFRase enzyme, which is having lower affinity for the inhibitor. Uses of cotrimoxazole. Its popularity in systemic infections has declined. Common indications of cotrimoxazole: urinary tract infections, respiratory tract infections, bacterial diarrhea and dysentery, pneumocystis jirovecii pneumonia in neutropenic and AIDS patients, typhoid and chancroid. Urinary tract infections. In acute cystitis, single dose 4 tablets are given. In upper and lower UTI, 3 to 10 days course has to be given. Chronic and recurrent prostatitis also, cotrimoxazole is given. Respiratory tract infections, upper and lower RTI, including chronic bronchitis, facio-maxillary infections, otitis media, cotrimoxazole is given. Bacterial diarrhea and dysentery. Cotrimoxazole is given in severe and invasive infections. In empirical therapy for infective diarrhea, pneumocystis jirovecii or carini pneumonia, seen in neutropenic patients and also AIDS patients. In this condition, cotrimoxazole is given prophylactically and therapeutically in high doses. Double strength tablet is given 4 times per day for 3 weeks. In typhoid, cotrimoxazole is now seldomly used. Chancroid, double strength tablet is previously given, now rarely used. adverse effects of cotrimoxazole. All the adverse effects that are seen with sulfonamides can be produced by cotrimoxazole. Commonly, nausea, vomiting, headache, stomatitis, and rashes are seen. Folate deficiency, megaloblastic anemia is infrequent. Blood dyscrasias are also rare. In pregnant women, cotrimoxazole has theoretical teratogenic risk. It causes neonatal hemolysis, methemoglobinemia when given in near-term pregnant women. In patients with renal disease, it will cause uremia. In AIDS patients with pneumocystis jirovecii pneumonia, it will cause fever, rash, and bone marrow hypoplasia. In elderly patients, bone marrow toxicity is seen.